SQL is structured query language that analysts use to work with databases. Data analysts usually use SQL to deal with large data sets because it can handle huge amounts of data, and I mean trillions of rows. That's a lot of rows to wrap your head around. So let me give you an idea about how much data that really is. Imagine a data set that contains the name of all 8 billion people in the world. It would take the average person 101 years to read all 8 billion names. SQL can process this in seconds. Personally, I think that's pretty cool. Other tools like spreadsheets might take a really long time to process that much data, which is one of the main reasons data analysts choose to use SQL when dealing with big data sets. Let me give you a short history on SQL. Development on SQL actually began in the early 70s. In 1970, Edgar F. Codd developed a theory about relational databases. You might remember learning about relational databases a while back. This is a database that contains a series of tables that can be connected to form relationships. At the time, IBM was using a relational database management system called System R. Well, IBM computer scientists were trying to figure out a way to manipulate and retrieve data from IBM System R. Their first query language was hard to use, so they quickly moved on to the next version, SQL. In 1979, after extensive testing, SQL, now just spelled SQL, was released publicly. By 1986, SQL had become the standard language for relational database communication, and it still is. This is another reason why data analysts choose SQL. It's a well-known standard within the community. The first time I used SQL to pull data from a real database was for my first job as a data analyst. I didn't have any background knowledge about SQL before that. I only found out about it because it was a requirement for that job. The recruiter for that position gave me a week to learn it. So I went online and researched it and ended up teaching myself SQL. They actually gave me a written test as part of the job application process. I had to write SQL queries and functions on a whiteboard. But I've been using SQL ever since, and I really like it. And just like I learned SQL on my own, I wanted to remind you that you can figure things out yourself too. There's tons of great online resources for learning, so don't let one job requirement stand in your way without doing some research first.